Why did that happen? Why did stream do that? Like, I... As for the cops, otherwise, it's... my stream quality says it's good, so I don't know why it disconnected like that. That was weird.
The only thing anyone really cares about in Kamurocho these days, though, is the murders. Over 3 months, three Kansai Yakuza have turned up dead. Most think it's the Tojo clan making some kind of power move in the ongoing turf war.
This one's missing its eyes, too.
Oof, that's intense.
That's not the only thing, though. All three of them were missing their eyes. It's in one little corner of this city that I run a detective agency. I work alongside my partner, Kaito-san. Funny enough, he's ex-Tojo. And me? I'm Takayuki Yagami. Used to be a lawyer, but I put that life behind me 3 years ago. As for my badge, it's barely even a decoration at this point.
God damn it. I do not know why my stream shut off like that all of a sudden. Like, I'm not having internet issues at all. I do not understand why that happened. Like, my internet's good right now. I'm baffled. Three blind mice. What a messy office. They got pinball machines, so that's neat.
Here, I'll scrounge up the rest for you later.
What about your cut?
I'll get it eventually. All of this goes to the client.
Gotcha.
Anyway, I'm gonna swing by Genda-sensei's place. See if he's got any work.
Don't hold your breath. For a lawyer's office, things are slow as shit over there.
You're aware they're one of our best clients, right?
Yeah. I know you used to work there. But don't show up empty-handed. Here, buy him some sweets or something. At least go through the motions.
So generous. My boy's all grown.
Don't mention it, Dad. Now get going.
Takayuki seems to be a pretty fun character.
Even come in a box.
Huh?
Well, Genda-sensei's got a pretty good sweet tooth. If you get me.
Right. I'll go pick some up.
Alright. I wanna look around the office. See what we've got to, What? I can't play... Why is there a pinball machine in this office if I can't play fucking pinball? I mean, I don't even like pinball, but... Why would you do that? Why would you do that? In these games? I mean... Come on! The fucking... This is the fucking minigame... These games are minigame heaven, right? Like... Where am I supposed to go? Let's see, over here. There we go. Some bum over there, over at Earth Angel, kept pestering me to drink. Can't go that way? Right. Gotta go this way. Okay. I haven't played... This is all new content to me. What are you saying? Haven't drank this much in a while. Damn fun party, though. I I saw Mr. Train hit me by a porno magazine. Buying a porno magazine. I wonder who Mr. Train hit me is. Group day was a total bust. Those hags were older than me. That's rude. Guy was a complete scumbag. See, this is why I hate walking here. Huh. Alright. Did I buy it? Oh, what? Okay. Arigato gozaimasu. Alright. Oh, cutscene. Ooh.
You just bought some of them Doriaki, yeah? Sorry, but they're mine now.
What?
Are they?
What?
I've been after one of those things for days. You just bought
them. What?
Fucking box.
Why have you been after them for days, dude? What?
Was that smart ass?
I am so baffled by this guy's motives. Like, wall jump strike. You can perform a wall jump by pressing sprint toward a wall. On top being, ooh, interesting. Here. Ooh, interesting. I am curious. Oh, yeah. What? Why are you telling me to do this in the middle of a... What? What? Why did it... Why is it... Why did it decide right in the middle of a battle is the right time to give me a tutorial on fucking, how to... What? Cool. What?
He's getting into trouble.
Captain Hamura.
We're gonna have to fight them too? Captain of Matsugane family, a Tojo clan subsidiary. Alright. Oh, is that his kid? No?
Our boy Tak here doesn't start shit without a real good reason. And that means it was you. You dumbasses jumped the wrong guy.
No.
You know this guy's like a son to the Matsugane patriarch, right? Know what I'm trying to say, asshole?
Hey, come on, Cap. Can't we just let it be?
No can do.
Oof.
This right here just became a matter of Matsugane family honor.
What? Well, that was unnecessary.
Kengo, you haven't met our buddy Tak. He's a guy you want to know. Hotshot detective type.
Right. It's good to meet you.
The boss paid
this. Man, all the Yakuza are just so fly.
Made him into a damn good attorney. Guy even managed to get a bona fide serial killer off the hook.
Seriously?
Shit.
That's incredible.
Right? Damn shame seeing talent like that get erased.
Totally.
Get this, though. The first thing that killer did when he got loose?
stabbed his girlfriend to death. Can you believe that?
Holy shit. Maybe it is more like Monster than I thought.
Yep. Guy got the death penalty and everything. They get around to hanging his ass, Tuck.
Not yet, no.
Hmm.
Oh, what the hell's taking him so long?
Here. This is the money from that detective. The rest is yours. I already took my cut.
Good. You're finally getting the hang of this whole debt collecting thing.
Yeah, thanks to you.
Ah, so I'm debt collecting for the Yakuza.
You mind asking him something? How long is he gonna stick around? Not wise to stay in town after you get kicked out of the family.
Oh.
But, I can look the other way since the boss likes you so much.
Speaking of, how's Matsugane-san doing?
None of your damn business, I'd say. Come on, let's go.
Hmm. I don't know where I'm going. I'm just kind of walking. Let's see. Degenerate lowlifes, ruthless thugs, and all sorts of other scoundrels constantly roam the streets in search of a fight. You can choose to run away from or outright ignore these thugs, but teaching them a lesson will net you some SP and the occasional item. Be warned that cops will show up if your fights take too long, so leave the area immediately if you don't want to end up in jail. Oh, that's interesting. Talking to our new employees gives me life. Interesting. I'm not gonna read everything I see. That's too much work. Are you guys gonna? Oh shit! You're gonna fight me, I see. My bad. Yeah, cool. Let's hope this is a better. There we go. Cool. All right. Wrong direction. Thank you.
Hey there, Sari-san. Look, Dorayaki. Extra fancy. Law office, where I used to work. Things haven't changed much these past 3 years. Hello, Yagami-san. Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. You, getting situated?
Yes. Everyone here is just great.
He seems sweet.
So I hear you're good. Passed the bar with top marks and everything. How'd you end up in this dump and not in the bigger office?
Huh? Well, you see, that's...
I hear you over there, Yagami.
Evening, Kendo-sensei. Other than my real dad, there's two people I look up to like a father. Kendo-sensei is one of those people. He gave me a job here. Before I'd even gotten out of law school. Shintani-sensei out for the night?
I can't keep track of that boy. I'm
sure you're happy, though. You don't have to deal with him.
Huh?
You two can't stand each other. You hate each other's guts. Be honest with me.
Hold on now. Shintaro's like a mentor to me. So, about that job you have.
If you really want that job, you're gonna have to get along. So show your senpai a little more respect.
Oh, Genda-sensei. I got you some dorayaki. Just sit right there. I'll grab you one. Sorry? Did you eat them all?
All but half. Hope you don't mind.
Say, sorry, son. Got any work lined up for me?
No.
So, what are the chances you've got some work for me, Genda-sensei?
Work, huh? How long are you gonna keep doing this to yourself, Yagami? You know how dangerous this city is.
Wouldn't be many cases for me if Kamurocho was a safe place.
Uh-huh. Cases like collecting debt for the Yakuza.
Hey, better that than no work at all, am I right?
You call that detective work? You're practically a mercenary.
Fine by me. I was never too hung up on being a detective anyway.
Listen, Yagami.
Yeah?
You ever thought about becoming a lawyer again?
I haven't.
And why is that?
Take a good look at me, Genda-sensei.
Mm-hmm.
These eyes aren't exactly the best judge of character. I think I made that clear a few years ago. What use am I as a lawyer if I can't tell good from bad?
Knock it off, Yagami. Stop beating yourself up. What happened to Emmy was tragic, yes, but it wasn't your fault.
It doesn't matter whose fault it is. I never want to deal with something like that again. So, have any work for me?
But that's kind of the work of a...
guy's got to stay busy, you know?
Criminal defense lawyer, isn't it?
Emmy Chung, all that. It doesn't matter what you've got, just... give me something.
How about a divorce case? I have some evidence that needs collecting. It'll be the usual deal. Stake out a love hotel, snap some photos, tail the guy. Dig through some trash. You in?
I'm in. A job's a job.
I give up. I'll send you the details later. And next time, don't bring a gift, you hear? Doesn't feel right taking them from guys too broke to pay for them.
Anything you say.
Oh. What's this?
Genda Law Office. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yagami-san, that was Shintani-sensei.
Hmm?
Apparently, he wants your help gathering evidence for a murder.
Huh?
Hmm. When are we working a murder case?
And this is the first I've heard of it, too.
Go give Shintani a hand, Yagami. This blows that divorce I was gonna send you on out of the water.
Been okay.
Since we had a murder case.
Shintani-sensei says he's waiting for you at Tender, that bar on Taihei Boulevard.
Tender? I'm there all the time.
Just making sure.
Oh, I want to talk to this kid. Can I talk to this kid? Nope. Roads, wow. Cars. Honestly, for some reason, I wasn't expecting cars. Like, I don't remember cars driving along the road in either of the other Yakuzas I have seen. But, that's a pretty small sample size, so. What? I didn't mean to climb up on that. Move! Oh, right here? Oh, I thought that was a... I thought that was a person just standing there waiting for a hug. This isn't the right place, is it? Is it? This can't be the right place. No, not the right place. I see. I'm really bad at reading maps, like, in general. I'd say this is a real hole-in-the-wall place.
It's called Tender. Got my first job here 20 years back.
It's a nice-looking place.
Asuda-san never changes. Running a bar must keep you young.
Hey, Todd. Shintani-sensei's in the back.
Great. We've got some business to talk.
Surprised to see me?
I'd be more surprised if I didn't.
Who's that, Tak? A detective buddy?
Not exactly, Mari. This one's a client.
Won't be your client for long if you don't show up on time. You're late.
Come on. You called me here totally out of the blue. Chill out, maybe. Oh, and I'm getting a drink.
I'm paying.
Let's call it a business expense.
Sassy.
Here's a familiar face. Kyohei Hamura, from the Matsugane family.
I ran into him.
We know him.
Actually. Ticket, he's your client?
Yep. Got hauled in earlier. We're charging him with murder.
Seriously?
Seriously.
Huh.
So, the Matsugane patriarch came to us for his defense. Genda-sensei is the go-to guy for all his legal problems, you know?
How'd you end up in the driver's seat, then?
Genda-sensei gave him my card. Gotta say, not looking forward to defending a Yakuza.
Tough luck, I guess.
Anyway, you're coming with me to the station. Need to have a word with Hummer. You got way more Yakuza experience than me, after.
I suppose I do.
Let me give you a rundown of the case first. The victim was a Yakuza. A Kansai guy. Part of the Kyori clan. They found his body tossed in a dumpster just about a week ago.
Hold on. This is...
The guy who got his eyes gouged out? Yep.
Rough.
Cops think Hamura's the one who did it.
Hell of a case, man.
This is the third Yakuza they've found like this. Fortunately, we're not dealing with a triple homicide here, so the media isn't swarming. Hamura's got an alibi for the first two incidents. This third murder is the only one they're pinning on him.
So they won't admit the cases are connected?
No. Makes sense. Three bodies and not a single suspect isn't exactly giving the cops credibility. Guess they just want to get this case closed and move on. Force it through. And hey, the victim was Yakuza. Nobody really cares who hangs for it.
Clever thing is rewarded. As conversations progress, you may come across a point where you'll have to select a response. During that critical thought process, you'll be able to gain SP bonus if you consecutively select the best choices to gather information as quickly and efficiently as possible. If you choose unwisely, you'll lose your chance to gain that SP bonus. When you have the chance to gain a bonus, the number of good choices will show at the top right of the screen. The number of stars displayed represents the number of good choices within the selection. Okay.
Why'd they come after Hamura, of all people?
Two reasons. First, the victim was a Kansai Yakuza from a group that's been making inroads in Kamurocho and picking fights with the Tojo clan along the way. Odds are, this was a Tojo guy wanting to send a message. And as you know, Hamura fits the bill.
And the other reason?
Hamura and the victim were seen having a fight on the day of the crime.
I'm guessing there's security camera footage then. Has Hamura said anything to you?
Yeah. He told me he didn't do it. Claimed the cops were falsely accusing him.
So he insists he's innocent, huh?
You think if I can ask that third question.
Just curious.
I don't know. I don't really care. If he says he's innocent, I gotta prove he's innocent. It's my job.
Fair enough. A murder where both the perpetrator and the victim are Yakuza. No time to mess around. I need to get to the core of this case.
I think I know enough. We should get to the station.
You go on ahead. I've got some calls to make first. Just take a cab there.
Will do.
New info has been added to your case file. Kamurocho serial killing, persons of interest updated. Kamurocho serial killing, case synopsis updated. Alright.
Leaving already, Tak? And only one drink in.
What can I say? I'm a busy man.
Funny you should say that. Another customer of mine has a job for you.
You don't say.
I'll tell you about it when you're not so swamped, okay?
Hey, I'm not about to pass up a paying gig.
Then come back when you and Shintani-sensei are done.
Alright then. Hope I don't forget that. Why are there so many arrows? What? What's this? What are all these? Why are there so many of these? I'm trying to understand. I don't understand. Oh, are these just... I have no idea what these are. Oh, these are all taxi locations, I think. Where am I currently? I'll just go... keep going forward, then. Alright. Taxi. Oh, wrong side. All right. Oh. Didn't realize I had to do anything else.
We just keep running into each other tonight, eh, Doc? Why the long face?
Hamura-san. I'm Shintani from the Genda Law Office. The Matsugane family asked us to represent you.
And I'm glad you said yes, Shintani-sensei. We're gonna get along real good. Just like my boss and Genda-sensei.
Right.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that, but...
let's get started. I'll be taking point. Yagami here will be doing the legwork to try and back up your claims.
No better guy to do it.
I'll do what I can.
So, they brought you in under suspicion of murder. Can you tell me more about that?
What do you want to know?
Whether or not you killed the guy.
Doesn't really matter. Your job's getting me out of this mess, regardless of the truth.
No, because if I find out you actually did it...
You'll drop me?
Better. I'll make sure the prosecution puts you away for life.
This is bullshit! Just like you did that serial killer, huh?
Yagami?
All the evidence at the time pointed to Shinpei Okubo being innocent. That's why I chose to trust him.
But then, that Okubo guy... Well, he proved us all wrong. Murdered his girlfriend in cold blood.
Come on, Tom. Let's be honest about what you were really focused on at the time. You wanted that precious acquittal so bad, you didn't even stop to think you were setting a murderer loose. Right?
What happened to innocent until proven guilty?
Try saying that to Emi Terasawa's parents. That's why you quit, right? You couldn't face him.
This duck's tilt back and forth is making me dizzy.
Sure. Why not?
You good to go?
I'm fine. Keep going.
My apologies. Now, let's start with the victim. Toshiro Kume, 34 at his time of death. A member of the Kansai-based Kyori clan. Around 6 a.m. on the 4th of December, the police got a 110 call from someone who found his corpse in a pile of garbage.
I hear you and this Kume had some kind of argument before he died.
Yep.
Did the police say what evidence points to you being the killer? Do they have anything substantial?
Nope. Bastards are keeping their lips sealed. Ain't that right, Shintani-sensei?
Yes. At this point in the investigation, the cops won't tell me what they've got against you. Your words are the only thing we'll have till the trial.
That's fucked up.
Is what it is.
Anything else you want to ask, Yagami?
Start with the alibi.
Is that my alibi? What time did they think Kume died?
Apparently between 2 and 3 in the morning. The cops were drilling me real hard about where I was around then.
And? Where were you?
At a sauna. A spot called Sauna Goten. Spent the night getting a steam.
But there's no proof you were actually there, huh? Otherwise you wouldn't be in here.
Pretty much. Someone should have seen something, though.
Let's see.
Where did you and Kume have your fight?
Out in front of a club, Amor, over on Supon Street. Me and a few Matsugane boys had a little run-in with a Kyori guy. Turns out that was your boy, Kume.
And who started the fight?
Who do you think? I'm not gonna let some Kansai punk strut around with the other place. I'd already thrown a few drinks back at that point, too.
What time did this all go down?
Just past 9.
So what happened after you and Kume had your standoff? Went your separate ways?
Nah, I tried to split, but I had my boys grab him, dragged him into a moor.
What?
I thought it was just a little scuffle, though. You're saying you abducted Kume on a crowded public street?
Yep. Amor's one of the family businesses. So I went in, kicked the customers out, and kicked the crap out of Kume. But I'm telling
that
you,
doesn't
I
sound
didn't kill the guy.
That...
Just tossed him out the back door when I was done with him. I left right after, too. A few minutes before midnight.
So you were seen dragging Kume into the club. and he was found in the morning with his eyes gouged out. I'd arrest you too if I was a cop.
Mm-hmm.
What do we have on the victim?
Toshiro Kumi, 34. Run-of-the-mill Kyori grunt.
Was Kumi alone when you ran into him? Hard to believe he'd take that kind of risk in hostile territory.
It was him and one more. Probably another Kyori asshole. Don't know his name, though.
So there are two of them. How many of you?
I'd say there was probably five, including me.
Why didn't you guys take Kume's friend in, too?
We tried. Bastard ran in the goddamn room.
Who's the detective in charge of the case?
Kuroiwa, from organized crime. Shintani-sensei is probably real familiar with him.
Damn. More so because he's one of those brutes with a badge. Pretty sure the Kyori murders are his case.
I can't stand him. Guy doesn't know rat's ass about Yakuza.
I think I've heard enough for now.
We'll get going then.
Loading.
Head over to Sonico 10 for me. See if Hamra's alibi holds water.
All right.
If we can prove he was there, we won't even have to go to trial. I'll give you a ring tomorrow for the report. Later.
Okay. I'm gonna run forever. Since there's nothing that'll keep me from doing that. Get out of the way. Oh, you get out of the way. Nope. Is this? Talk to this guy.
Excuse me. You work here?
Yeah. Come on in, friend.
Actually, I'm not a customer. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Sure. What do you need?
I'm here about a murder. Yakuza who had his eyes gouged out.
Oh, a detective came by for the same thing. Wanted to know if their suspect was with us the night of the incident. And you are a reporter?
Something like that, yeah. This is Hama, captain of the Matsugane family. Did he come in on the night of the crime?
I'll tell you the same thing I told the cops. I make it a point not to remember anyone specific, you know?
You get a lot of customers in and out, huh?
Up to the last train, at least. And there it's only in till morning. You know how it is. People drop in, wait for the trains to start up again. Same as any other night.
Interesting. So everyone who comes in stays till morning, huh? And as long as I can prove Hummer was here, we'll have an alibi.
Oh, yeah. The cops mentioned something kind of similar.
If I can prove that Hamura was there on the night of the crime, then that will solve everything. But there supposedly wasn't any promising evidence to point to an alibi.
You guys don't have a security camera? Something we could check, see who was here?
We do, but it deletes all its footage every 3 days. Privacy and all. It was already long gone by the time the cops came.
Got it. Thanks. Sorry to bother you.
Alright.
Hey, you're out here pretty often, right? Did you see a Yakuza head into Sonic 010 the night of December 3rd?
Why would I know that? You're crazy, mister.
Okay.
Hey, you have a sec? I'm looking for info on a Yakuza who went to Sonic 010 on the night of December 3rd. You seriously expect me to remember something from that long ago? I'm trying to work here. Get lost!
Okay. What are you doing? What's your job? You say you're trying to work.
Excuse me. I'm looking for info on a Yakuza who stopped by Sonic 010 on the night of December 3rd. Did you see anything? This is the guy. Name's Hamura.
I can't say I know him. There's tons of Yakuza around here. Though, now that you mention it, I remember something about a host getting smacked in the face that night.
By a Yakuza?
Yep. Don't think he got hurt too bad, though. Pretty sure it happened right around midnight.
All things interesting. The incident.
But when I went to check things out, the Yakuza was long gone. The host was just standing there shouting. That help at all?
Any idea who the host was?
Nah. I mean, they all kind of have that pretty boy look. Doubt I'd be able to recognize him if he was standing right in front of me.
Does anyone else know about this?
I don't know.
Guess this isn't much of a lead then.
Thanks for your help.
Interesting fashion choices. I'll go this way. Get the fuck out of the way, all of you. Someone sent me something. Present! So many presents! Did I say Ace Detective Pack? Hold on.
Yo.
You're still here? I thought you'd have left hours ago.
I was gonna. I realized all I do at home is pass out. Did go for a drink, though.
Oh, now you're having another. You know that bottle's mine.
Well, Genda sensei give you any work?
Yep, probably thanks to the dorayaki. He wants me to scrounge up some evidence.
But he didn't eat any of the dorayaki.
You got this from Genda? I thought it was all about civil suits now. Criminals don't pay the bills, right?
This one comes straight from Matsugane-san. Turns out, Hamura went and got himself arrested.
What the hell?
For one of those Kyore clan murders.
You mean that eye-gouging shit?
Mm-hmm. Just dropped by the jail to see him. He claims he's innocent, though.
Huh. Crazy.
You said it, pal.
Not interested? I can't say I blame you after what Hamura did. Booting you from the family was a low blow. If you want, I'll handle it solo.
Look, don't worry about it. I'm the one who fucked up, not him. Either way, we've got the case. Count me in.
Good.
Well, I guess I should get some rest. All right. No. What? Oh, I thought that was... Since it's, you know... Fucking... coat hangers, I thought it was... You know, outfit changing, but apparently not. Yeah, I'll rest up. Oh, that's coming from my controller.
Morning, sunshine. I'm on Nakamichi Street.
I was really confused where that sound was coming from for a second.
Little cafe, killer coffee. Come here.
Another impromptu meeting?
Don't whine. I thought you liked keeping busy.
I miss what was being said. I was too baffled by the sudden use of the controller mic. Or controller speaker. Yeah. Oh. It's right there. Not there. That makes more sense. Meeting for coffee at a... I thought we were going to be meeting for coffee at a burger place. I was very confused. What the fuck? Where am I going? No, I'm going up. What? Very confusing. I hate maps.
Hey, over here.
I'm very bad at navigation. Terrible navigation.
Right. Anyway, I asked around near Sonico 10. Couldn't get anyone to back up Hamura's alibi, though.
All right. Good work.
So, what'd you call me out here for?
Something came up. Take a look at this. Cops released it to the media. It's the camera footage from the morgue. Hamura and Kuma are both in here. Clear as day.
Damn. Didn't realize the cops had their hands on this. This could be pretty bad.
Ready? I'm gonna play.
Uh-oh.
Kume's the poor bastard getting dragged into the club.
Explains why Kumi's buddy there is running for his life.
Yep. Got a name, too. Akira Murase. Another Kyori thug. Word is, he hasn't left Kamurocho after getting interrogated by the cops. By the look of things, there must be a Kyori hideout nearby.
Crazy how clear it all is. Kamura can't just talk his way out of this.
Yep. And there's more. Take a look at this.
Did something else happen? What else could the camera have caught?
1 hour later, everyone leaves, except for Hamura and Kume. Even the owner hightails it.
Oh.
Wait, why would they stick around?
Who knows? Our pal Hamura never mentioned this part. Now, this happened around 10 p.m. Meaning, there was another 4 hours before Kume's suspected time of death. The question is, what were the two of them doing all that time?
There's no doubt that Hamura was alone with Kume right before he died. What did Hamura say he did with Kume again?
Hamura said he threw Kume out of the club around midnight.
Kume?
After that, he left the club himself. Went to the sauna.
Right. But I want to hear how it all went down from a different angle. That's where you come in, Yagami. You gotta talk to the guy in charge of Amora.
Back up a second. You're the lawyer here. I get that. You decide what kind of investigation we need for the trial. But don't tell me how to do my job.
Yeah, but aren't you gonna talk to him either way?
All the same, I'd appreciate it if you'd stop barking orders at me.
Uh-oh. Tense. Garrett. Fuck stairs. There's not a ton of punks that need their ass kicking in this game. So, oh! I spoke too soon. Spoke way too soon. Here we go. Club Amor. This is where everything went down between Hamura and Kume. The angle of the footage should help me find where the camera is. Seriously? It's right there.
Suspicious.
All right. This is a security camera that gave us our footage. Better go talk to the owner of Amora. Why did I need to find the camera? Before I talk to the dude?
Something?
Actually, I was wondering if you have a minute to talk.
About?
About December 3rd.
Oh, damn. I just be saying damn for the sake of it.
I'll
for the sake off. Of it. Ah!
Know it's our manager.
Very good one, Jam. Good one.
Manager, huh? Is him?
Oh, it is.
What's his name?
Aragaki.
Think you could get in touch with him for me? We need to have a chat.
I could try. Hold on. I knew this was gonna happen. He never has his phone on during the day. He usually hangs out near here, though.
You mean in Kamurocho?
Yep, usually.
All right. I'll go take a look around.
If you don't mind me asking, how? You're just gonna walk the whole city?
No, I have a plan. Someone I can use to help me find him. The name and photo, it shouldn't be much of a problem.
If you say so, man. Good luck.
Okay. Thank
Thanks
you.
Thanks for the help.
Oh yeah, there's supposed to be a back door too. Hamura said something. Oh boy. So this is the back of the club. Oh, it's a security camera. Oh wait, it's broken. Damn. The night of the crime, Hamura said he and Kume left the club from this door. The camera would have caught that if it had been working. As for where the owner is, I know just the person to ask. I have a feeling he'll be where he always is. Manti Internet Cafe. Huh. Wow. I've always interested to be in a city that's this, you know, crammed, you know, with tiny frickin' alleyways like that. Like, I don't know. I think it's cool. I think all the little nooks and crannies make a place incredibly interesting. Shut up. Go away. Seriously? Dude. You know what? Fine. If you're gonna be that way, I am just gonna kick your ass. That was entirely unnecessary, my dude. Entirely unnecessary. I'm taking the escalator. I don't know why I find that so funny. It would have been so much faster to just walk up the stairs. Using an escalator in a video game is fucking dumb. What? Am I not in the right place? Oh, no, this does seem like an internet cafe. See here? No. Here? No. No. Any of these? What the fuck? What the fuck? Here. Here. Here.
Somehow I knew I'd find you here.
Ah, Yagamishi. You here to join this raid I'm about to get going? Probably not, huh? What can I do for you?
Got something I need a guy like you for, Tsukumo. This is Makoto Tsukumo. He's a character.
Seems like.
Tsukumo makes a living digging up dirt on the internet. Modern day informant, if you will.
More detective work, I assume? What's the mark this time? A lost cat? Someone go missing?
I'm looking for someone. The owner of Club Amura, a man named Aragaki. He's probably somewhere nearby, but I don't have time to scour over the either.
You got that right. Searching on foot for cavemen. Here, can I see your phone for a quick second?
My phone? Sure.
What do we have here? You already have the chatter app, Yagamishi.
I do? Oh. I guess it came pre-installed.
Well, you're in luck. In my hands, this stupid app becomes a powerful way to find people.
Really? How?
Hold on. I'm busting into their servers now. And there we go. Here, take a look. Go ahead, try searching for something. Maybe a name?
That would be Aragaki.
Alright.
Okay, and let's limit the time period while we're at it. Say, today.
Okay.
See? That map will tell you the GPS position of all the relevant chatter posts. I'm not gonna lie. I had to give myself admin privileges to get that one, though.
Wow.
128 hits. We're gonna need to narrow down the search.
Not sure what else we can put in, though.
Didn't you say the name of the club, Yagamishi? Some crazy French word?
Oh, yeah. It's Club Amour.
Great. Let's try Aragaki and Club Amour. Well, looky there. Narrowed it down to one.
So Aragaki wrote this, huh?
Nope.
just someone who saw it. It's still a massive hint, though. See, it got posted only 10 minutes ago. Meaning the poster might still be nearby. So, if I were you, I'd get down there and see if you can find out where your man went.
Neat.
Mark the spot on your map, Yagamishi. Hope it comes in handy. Good luck out there.
Appreciate it. Oh, you try to get out more, okay?
Why on earth would I do that?
What a pure soul. A true gamer. What the fuck was that? Did I? I didn't just accidentally. I didn't. Did I? What the fuck? I thought something just collapsed. I am so confused. I don't know what that was. I don't know what just happened. I'm never aware of what's going on, man. Beat it, punks. I don't have time for your shit. Seriously, they're tenacious. Very tenacious. Oh, do I gotta go in the... Oh, it's a pop out, never mind. I don't see anyone I can interact with. Here, bud? You're not in here. Nothing's in here. Nobody's in here. You saw a ninja? Interesting. I wonder if that's gonna be relevant at some point. I see no one to talk to. Oh, you! I can talk to you!
Got a second?
Sure. I can spare a few of those. What's up?
I'm looking for the owner of a club called Amour. Any idea where he is?
Actually, yeah. Just saw him. Wasn't in a great mood from the look of it. Must have really lost big time on the pachinko slots.
Any idea where he was heading?
Toward Taihei Boulevard. Probably getting sushi, if I had to guess.
Sushi? Really? Isn't that a little pricey for a guy who just lost a bunch of money?
You don't get it. You get sushi after a big loss to cheer yourself up. What's 10 more grand if you've already lost 50 or 100? Winning's what makes you stingy. Feels like it'd be a waste to blow your earnings on something dumb.
Huh. I've never thought about it. Anyway,
he has a good point. Lunch.
I'll head over to that sushi joint.
Lots of going back and forth. Guys came from this direction. Well, sort of. Not really, never mind. What? I can walk on the cars? Interesting.
Time.
Ah.
Aragaki-san, the owner of Amour.
And you are?
Yagami from the Yagami Detective Agency. I want to talk about what happened on the night of December 3rd.
Oh, yeah? Sorry, not ringing any bells.
Come on, you and I both know that's not true.
Well, it is. I don't know a damn thing.
Why don't I jog your memory, though? I've got something to show you.
Oh, okay. Let's see. The time was 9 o'clock on the night of the incident murder. Victim Kume is being shown to horse in the club more.
Take a look. On the night of the crime, you left a moor with these Matsugane guys, leaving Hamura victim.
Excuse me, sorry.
You're knee-deep in this.
Guess I can't argue with that logic.
Don't worry, I won't ask for anything too out there. Just a bit of your time. I'm working on Hamura's defense, and I'm hoping you're the silver bullet.
Oh yeah? Whatever, I'll talk.
Actually tracked him down.
Appreciate the help. Now, what went down around 9 p.m. on the night of December 3rd?
Well, Captain Hamura brought that Kansai punk Kume in here. It was out of the blue. Caught me off guard.
Were there any other customers here at the time?
Just a few. They bailed when Hamura came busting in here. Who wouldn't? I ended up sending the girls home, too. Once everybody was gone, the Matsugane guys just laid into Kume for almost an hour. You didn't hear that from me.
You're good. Don't worry.
Then, right around 10, something kind of weird happened. Hamura kicked everyone out of the club. Even me.
And the only ones left inside were Hamura and Kume.
Yep.
You know why Hamura kicked everyone out?
He said Kume reminded him of an old friend. Claimed they needed to have a chat. Alone. At least that's how he worded it.
And that didn't seem weird to anyone?
Well, the Matsugane boys had plenty to say about it. If the boss tells you to leave, you get the heck out. No clue what went down in the club after that.
Tell me about the camera out back. Broken one.
Oh, that?
How long's it been like that?
For about a month. Some drunk asshole chucked a rock. Cracked it right open. That was just for show, though. Never actually worked in the first place. How much use?
Alright.
Did you just sit and watch while the Matsugane tore into Kumin?
What do you mean? What else could I have done?
I called the cops on them, for one. Not like they're especially good for business. Nor is a dead body.
Come on. They'd have killed me if I did that. And frankly, it didn't look like they were hurting him too bad. If anything, they were going easy on him.
Interesting.
Meaning what?
Like just smacking him around a bit. Nothing too serious. Once in a while, they'd hit him a little harder. To complete, I guess.
What the fuck's going on outside? Hold on.
A detective, yeah. A guy named Kuroiwa. Apparently with organized crime.
What did you tell him?
Not a lot.
Just a tow truck.
Same stuff I told you.
Soft flashing lights on.
Tearing this place apart. Trying to find bloodstains from Kume. You know, with that luminol stuff. I thought I'd wiped all that up before they got here, but that sure was a waste. Turns out blood's tougher to clean up than I thought. Convinced the murder happened here.
Was there that much blood before you wiped it up?
No, not really. I told you, they barely even made Kume bleed.
Sounds like he didn't die here.
Well, I certainly wouldn't know.
Alright.
Well, thanks. This is a huge help.
done here?
Whoops. Just kicked over the fucking... I don't understand the use of the controller fucking speaker for that shit. I don't get it. That's a weird gimmick, the controller speaker in general. I don't get it. It's more frustrating. It's more annoying than anything. Seriously? Dude, fuck off. What's your issue? What's your damage, man? Huh? What's your fucking damage? Why are you chasing me all the way out here? I should have done the special thingy. Alright. This way. There we go. Stairs. Door. It's very loud outside.
What the? Why is she here?
How about you ask her yourself? Okay.
Good to see you.
Who is she? Public prosecutor. Mafuyu Fuji.
Don't worry, it's not what you think. Before you ask, she's not here to win your heart again.
Let's make one thing clear. We never do.
Guess I misspoke. Don't say
ugh.
I'm here on business. That should be obvious.
Business? Okay.
The prosecutor's office is pressing murder charges against Kyohei Hamura of the Matsugane family.
Yeah.
You're involved.
Do that.
Aren't you, Yagami-kun?
Word travels fast.
Nothing that happens in Genda's office gets away from me.
Saori-san just can't keep a secret, huh?
Huh.
Not with me. We go way back.
Since you were kids, right?
Yep.
Back to Hamura, though. They're already pressing charges. They only just arrested him.
Apparently the prosecutor's had his eye on Hamura for a while now. He's just been lying in wait for the perfect moment to strike.
And who the prosecutor is?
Your friend Izumita.
Somehow I knew it'd be him.
You haven't seen that guy since the whole not guilty verdict, huh, Tom?
Yep.
He's probably still sore about it.
Too bad Shintani's gonna be the one in charge of the case and not me.
You're really never becoming a lawyer again, are you?
I don't want to talk about it anymore. Genda-sensei asked me the same question.
I see.
Does the prosecution have any work for me? I'd be glad to cut you a discount.
You know what, Yagami-kun?
Hmm?
This detective business really doesn't suit you.
Cold.
Couldn't she have just called? Think she went through the trouble for a reason? Maybe you?
It's getting dark out. I should walk her back.
I really wish they would finish with whatever they're doing outside. The noise is bugging me.
Not so fast. Who are you?
Chief Prosecutor. And you're the Mikuno. What are you doing?
Well, I was planning to walk you home.
Really? That's so sweet.
Well, then. I apologize for my forcefulness.
Time no see, Yamamoto-sensei.
Courtroom just hasn't been the same without you around. Damn near breaks my heart.
Smug.
So you're defending Hamura, huh?
Nope, Shintani's handling it. I'm just collecting evidence.
Looks like you don't need that walk home off of you. Later.
Oh yeah, almost forgot. You're not a lawyer anymore. Even after your landmark acquittal. Too bad.
I only won because I was up against you.
Bullshit logic. That murder would have been behind bars. An innocent girl died because of you.
Tell me what was so bullshit about my defense then. Come on, say it.
Everything! That's enough, Izumi.
It's okay, Izumi-san. Thanks for thinking of me, Yagami-kun.
Farewell. Man, has that guy got Toro or what? If I was a chick, I'd be way into that. My bad. What do you do? About the case.
Mafu, you said there are pressing charges. You should go to Genda's. Let Shintani know what's going on. I want you there too.
Got it. See you over there then.
What is it now?
Look, just take a breather, huh? Count to 10 or something.
I really enjoy Kaido. I really enjoy him. Oh, hey, it's Tsukumo. Sorry to bug you, Yagamishi, but I kinda need to ask a small favor. Just think of it as paying me back for last time. Fair enough. What do you need me to do? Buy me a model figure. There's a specific one I've been looking for, and apparently they have it at Ebisu. Which makes sense, since they're a limited edition and sold out everywhere else. This may be my only chance to get it. Alright, I'll see what I can do. Ebisu. He must mean the pawn shop. That's not too far. Tsukumo's always helping me out, so I do owe him one. Poor guy's never felt too comfortable outdoors. Well, might as well go do my dude a solid then. Oh wait, I can climb over this car, right? Climb on top of the car. There we go. What's this? QR code. How do I... Camera. Scanning this QR code unlocked EX light bullet. Learn how to use it in the skill app. I don't want to do that right now. Whoa, wrong direction. Damn it. Is this the, Yes, this is a pawn shop.
いらっしゃいませ.
Ouch. Oh, did I buy it already? Alright, okay. Interesting. Ah, I see what I have to do. Okay. I was having trouble figuring out how to close out. I think this is what Tsukumo wanted, but how did he even know a pawn shop would have it? Well, guess I'll go make the handoff. All right. Get out of the way! Fuck you. Fuck you guys. Get out of the way! Move it! I'm just running into people on purpose now. Parkour! Right. A little bit farther down. Right here. Ah, I see.
Hey.
I brought you the goods. It is this one, right? Yep, that's the one. Many thanks. How much was it? Nah, it's on me. I'm paying you back for last time, remember? Really? Hey, that's pretty generous of you. No worries, though. Wouldn't it have been quicker to go yourself? What can I say? I'm a busy guy. Plus, there's this pre-order about to open up, so it's time to man the battle station. Huh. You've always got a reason to stay cooped up, huh? You never change. Nah, I shouldn't say that. You've improved a lot, actually. It's all thanks to you, Yagamashi. I might never have made human contact again if it weren't for you reaching out to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, speaking of which, you finally set foot out of your house, only to end up hiding away in a net cafe? Heh, well, the rent's cheap and the internet's fast. What more could you want in life? Besides, this is the perfect place for an informant to set up his base of operations. True. You always have been a big help, that's for sure. Either way, I'm lucky to have you. Right back at you. Yay! Once you become friends with someone, you'll sometimes receive items from them when you pay them a visit. If you don't get an item, try coming back later. I'm not bothering reading any of that. I think I get the gist. I should probably save. Yep. What's this? Interesting. No idea. Okay.
Here you go.
Hey, Yagami. The hell were you thinking sending Kaito here by himself? Guy acts like he owns a goddamn place.
All hail King Kaito.
Just sit your ass down, would you?
All hail.
So, we finally have some details from the cops. Murder specifics, forensic results, even their proof that Hamura is the one who did it.
Oh, that's yeah?
Good. Let's see it.
But first, just don't forget your role in all of this. Especially you, Yagami. At the end of the day, you're just a mercenary. The one who decides how this investigation goes is me. Understand?
You got it. It's your show. Now, why don't we look at those documents, Shintani-sensei?
That's more like it. First up is the crime scene. Around 6 a.m., morning of December 4th, police get a call about a body in the alleyway behind the mall. The officer who rushed to the scene confirmed the corpse on arrival.
Guess I need to read this. Quick search mode was used when examining pieces of evidence. You'll get a complete view of the object in question on the left side of the screen during quick search mode. On the right side of the screen, you'll see an enlarged view of the area as well as the cursor. The parts of the evidence you can see will appear in the enlarged view on the right side of the screen. Pressing X while on cursors, blah 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 blah. Good enough.
Suspicious.
Victim was a Kansai thug. Bottom feeder with the cure plan. Toshiro Kume.
Body we knew that.
Bruises, but the cause of death is pretty obvious. Two puncture wounds, straight through the eyes.
Jesus.
The cops think the murderer used something like an ice pick, pierced right into his brain.
My eyes hurt just thinking about it.
Oh, you're telling me. Looks like the murder weapon went through Kume's eyes, then tore him out when the killer took it back. Only natural to think the Tojo was trying to make an example out of him. You know, threaten to cure it.
Blah, blah, indeed. Yes, Jam.
damn likely that someone from the Tojo clan did.
And if we can figure out who it was, Hamura will be off the hook.
What? Find the real killer? That's a step too far. Priority number one is proving his alibi. We do that, we're in the clear.
Hmm. Something's not right. This is where the murder happened. Where's all the blood? Good question. I don't see anything else to search here.
Oh,
there we go.
There's pretty much no blood anywhere near the body. Meaning Kume was murdered in that alley. If I had to guess, I'd say he died in a moor.
Next, I need to figure out how they disposed of the corpse. Is there anything that would point to that? My shoes? No. Just gonna...
Suspicious.
Night of the crime, an employee from another bar tossed their trash out in this alley. Around 2 a.m. Didn't see anything out of the ordinary, though. In other words, Kume got dumped sometime between 2 and 6 a.m. when the body was found.
Interesting. Okay, come to think of it, where are the victim's possessions, like a wallet and cell phone?
Nothing was found in Kume's pockets. No wallet, no phone, nothing. Bet the murderer broke the phone. Cops tried one of those find my phone things, but came up empty-handed. Guess the killer at least tried to cover his tracks.
Alright. That was seemed kind of fruitless.
When you were over at a moor, doubt there's any traces left at this point. And it's apparently just out the back. Anyway, this is Kume, just before he died.
Before the killer took his eyes.
Come on, don't say stuff like that.
So what's the prosecution's angle on this?
Well. Try thinking about it in the context of the Tojo Kyori feud. Two other Kyori Yakuza turned up dead before this, each with their eyes gouged out. Not a far leap to assume the Tojo's responsible for all three murders. Follow?
There's a good chance the murders are the result of the Tojo clan versus the... I haven't heard the
Go on.
All right. This is how the prosecution thinks it all went down. December 3rd, just around 9 o'clock, right out front of Club Amor. An argument breaks out between Captain Hamura of the Matsugane family and Kume and Murase of the Kyore clan. Hamura and his thugs dragged Kume into the club. At which point, Murase abandons Kume and flees the scene. Hamura then locks Kume in a moor for around an hour, while he and his boys beat the daylights out of the guy. Around 10 p.m., Hamura kicks everyone out, leaving only himself and Kume in the club. Up to that point, their story matches the camera footage and the testimony we have from the owner of Amor. The prosecution's story continues as follows. Once the two of them were alone, Hamura tortured Kume even more violently. Then, between 2 and 3 a.m., he drove a sharp weapon into Kume's eye, killing him instantly. Once he finished gouging Kume's eyes out, Hamura dumped the body in the alley behind Amor. When questioned, Hamura said, Me and Kume left Amor around midnight. I went for a steam right after. But since no evidence can back up that claim, the prosecution doubts its credibility. 6 a.m. on the morning of the 4th, Kume's body was found. And 1 week later, they arrested Hamura.
Interesting touch putting his glasses back on his face.
So they've got three things. The camera footage, the bloodstains in the club, and Hamura's Swiss cheese alibi. Any of those alone wouldn't be enough to get a conviction. But with all three, the prosecution thinks they've got this case in the bag. End of the day, to them, it's just Yakuza offing Yakuza.
Guess there's lots of reasons for them to suspect Hamura.
Makes sense they'd see it that way. I'm more interested in what you think, though. Did Hamura actually kill Kume?
I don't know. The guy rubs me the wrong way, yeah. But I'm pretty sure he's innocent. A cunning Yakuza like Hamura wouldn't just offload the corpse in an alley like that. Too sloppy.
If
he really did it, forget about the eyes. We'd never even find the body.
Agreed. That's Arshintani-sensei. Prickliest guy in town. But damn if he's not a terrific lawyer.
With you there.
Was that supposed to be a compliment? What? Something wrong?
If Hamura didn't do it, the person who did is still out there somewhere.
Huh?
Just gotta find them if you want to clear Hamura's name.
Ha! You think we've got the manpower for that? Tracking down a criminal like that takes an entire organized front. Best leaving that to the cops, if you ask me.
Well, if they're trying to pin it all on this one guy, they're not gonna be out looking for him. You know? Like, a lawyer's job is only to prove reasonable doubt, not the defendant's innocence. To them, the truth is irrelevant.
Then what's your next move?
Gonna need some more info on the victim. Remember Kumi's buddy? The one who ran off when the Matsugane boys jumped him. Name's Akira Murase, from the Kyore clan. I want to hear what he has to say.
About what?
About what he did after he watched Kume get dragged into the club. Did he really just abandon his friend? It's hard to believe.
He's right. No self-respecting Yakuza would run off and leave his buddy to die. Murase must have at least attempted a rescue, but to find out for sure, that would mean...
Come on, man. Is this the time to go knocking on the Kyore clan's door? Sounds like suicide to me.
I bet they're out for blood after what happened to Kume.
One way or another, I want that info from Murase. You're the ones who have to figure out how to get it. That's a deal, remember?
Deal my axe. Poking a hornet's nest ain't gonna get us anything but stung.
He's right, though. Come on, Kaito-san.
Fine. First things first, we need to find out where the Kyore clan's hiding. We've got a base or something.
Probably quickest to just go ask Matsugane-san. He's got all the real Tojo clan dirt.
I guess I'll pass. Can't exactly waltz in. Spell it.
Yeah, I'll take care of this one by myself. I'll call you when I'm done.
All right. Running. Oh, punks. Oh, punk with a Did I just bust up somebody's motorcycle with a kick? A single kick? I'm tough. Car. Oh yeah. Tasty. Man, why do people keep dropping garrots? What a weird thing to have.
Here, right this way.
The Matsugane are an offshoot of the Tojo clan. Not the biggest Yakuza family on the block. They're a small branch that's low on the tree. But the family's patriarch, Mitsugu Matsugane, is like a father to me. And Kaito-san.
Excuse me. Yagami-san is here to pay you a visit.
Oh, so good to see you again, my boy. Now then, feels like ages since you last stopped by.
I know. I wonder why that is, huh? Could it be that you're the only one who's glad to see me?
Well, you have a point there. How's Kaito these days? Staying out of trouble?
He's okay.
If not for that incident, he'd still be part of the family. Hard to believe it's already been a year. The both of you are more or less the sons I never had.
The past is what it is.
True. But I'm glad to hear he's doing well under your watch.
I'm sure Kaito-san will always feel like my Aniki. If not for you, I would have taken another direction in life. I'd be a very different person, I think.
You'd have turned out just fine, my boy.
Excuse me. Tea.
So then, one would drag you back to an office where you're not exactly welcome.
Hamura is giving me some grief.
You see now, I was under the assumption Genda is handling the issue. Are you helping him out with the case now?
Shintani's got me looking for the Kyori clan. Just need to find them, so I can ask him a few things.
Not wise, my boy. You do know they're all up in arms right now. I'm sure you want this.
Don't worry. I just want to have a word.
Does the name, the Kajihira Group, mean anything to you?
No. Can't say that it does.
They're a Kansai outfit. They've got a front in the city. KJ Art Office down on Senryo Avenue. Be careful, though. There's Kyori crawling on every floor. These are Tojo clan streets, but that's their turf now.
Senryo Avenue. KJ Art, eh? I'll check it out.
I know you're busy. Although, you think I could visit your office someday soon? Keep it on the down low.
Yeah, of course.
He seems like a nice guy.
Kaito-san, just left the Matsugane office. The Kyore are shacked up in some place called KJ Art.
Huh. I guess we'll find her office.
Not sure. We won't know if we don't check it out ourselves.
You're thinking Stasia, huh? Sounds like the perfect time to use the drone as well.
That might be our only choice.
Fingers crossed. Anyway, I'll see you over there.
All right. apparently I can be your friend, huh? I don't know if I want to be your friend right now. Punks. Well, I'm just going to... Yep. Yeah. Come on, punk. Got him. I'm glad you enjoyed the show, lady. Alright. I think I'm gonna call it there for tonight. Since I'm just kind of getting back into the swing, I'm not gonna push it too hard. Thanks for coming. I'll be putting the VOD of this up on YouTube. If you're watching the VOD of this and you are new to the channel, please hit the follow button. And yeah. Thanks for coming. Thanks for yeah.